Mr. Ogene, I dare say that not many people in Muncie are too familiar with the situation in California with the grapes and the grape growers and the workers out there. What is that situation that brings you here to Muncie?
Well, the situation is basically one of a lack of protection for the farm worker under the National Labor Relations Act. We do not have collective bargaining rights, which would give us a right to hold secret ballot elections to let the farm worker decide for himself whether or not he wants a union. Now, on top of that, what of course gives the impetus to all of this is the fact that the poor working conditions of the migrant worker is the third most hazardous industry in the United States. The fact that the farm workers were excluded from unemployment insurance, health benefits, we don't have toilets in the fields, for example, washing facilities, many times not even cold drinking water in 100-degree weather. And then also I think perhaps we can just mention, for example, one statistic, the life expectancy of the 3 to 4 million farm workers in this country, 49 years.
Now, what do you hope to gain for the California grape worker by a visit to Muncie, Indiana? Why are you here?
Okay. We have found that as we've struck against the $164 million industry, grape industry in California, we have found that we cannot use ordinary tactics in order to get the workers out of the field. When the workers do come out of the field, the growers are able to get restraining orders through lower federal courts to keep immigration laws from being enforced. So what happens is that when we walk out of the fields, the growers are then able to get all the workers they want from the U.S.-Mexican border, people that carry what are called green cards, permanent residence visas, which are given to people who want to live in this country permanently. However, thousands of people live south of the border who commute to this country with those green cards in violation of the law, and it is not enforced. So the fact that we're immediately replaced just makes it impossible to just have everybody come out. Now, on top of that, the restrictions on our picketing through injunctions again, which of course we always win in appeals when we appeal to higher courts, but by the time we win in court, it's meaningless. So the only alternative, nonviolent alternative left is a boycott. We've launched an international boycott of California table grapes. We've got our people in about 30 to 40 cities, and it is quickly spreading to as many as 300 cities as concerned Americans all over the country have endorsed our boycott. In Canada, the Canadian Labor Congress there has endorsed our boycott. So I'm here in Indiana in order to help the Indiana Committee to Aid Farm Labor get started on the boycott, because Indiana has become a primary state for the rerouting of scab grapes. For example, we just finished cleaning Michigan. Well, those grapes that were in transit toward Michigan are now being sold to Indiana. And one of the major reasons we're not having tremendous victories in the major cities on the boycott is that we cannot prove legally through written affidavits that the grapes are unsanitarily picked.
We just have time for a quick question. How would somebody in Muncie, Indiana, or anywhere for that matter, recognize the California grape, assuming they were sympathetic with your cause? When you walk into the market, how do you know a California grape from a scab grape?
Okay. At any time during the year, the percentage of grapes on the market that are from California goes from 95% to 98%. Citizens here, concerned citizens that want to help us, can rest assured that any grape that they find in the state comes from California.
So in effect, your boycott is don't buy any grapes until we get this settled. Is that what you're asking?
Right. For example, we have the Arizona grape growers whose season only goes for a month in the summer, but they've been lending their labels to the growers in California and, you know, in violation of interstate commerce laws and so forth. And so, but the fact that, the percentage goes from 95 to 98%, especially in states like this where, for example, New York grapes never get here, just makes it quite simple. I just don't buy grapes.